In this video, I will review one of the strongest diode laser engravers currently available today. The Atomstack A70 Pro is a monster of a laser engraver, featuring a 70-watt diode laser source. Like its predecessors, the A70 Pro is also an open-frame laser engraver, but it has autofocusing, an improved frame, cable management, and steel rollers on all axes, which enables it to engrave with speed and precision. In this video, I have put it to the test to see how well it performs at laser cutting and laser engraving various materials. I will also test its mechanical stability and engraving precision. But first, I need to select the winner of the giveaway contest from my previous video, who will receive a free laser engraver from WeCreat. The video got many comments in the 2 weeks since publishing. First, I will export the comments to Excel, where I will be able to select the winner. There were 99 comments in total. Many different numbers were guessed, but the correct answer was 12. I removed the wrong answers from selection, and I was left with 73 comments that were competing for the prize. I selected the winner with a random number generator, and the lucky number is 25. Let's see who is the lucky winner. Congratulations to Gigantoid6666, who has just won a free laser engraver from WeCreat. Contact me, and we will arrange the prize. Thanks everyone for competing. I will leave a link in description, together with my exclusive $100 discount coupon if you decided to buy this machine. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe for more future giveaways. Atomstack A70 Pro features automatic air assist pump and removable touchscreen display for offline engraving using an USB thumb drive. This laser engraver is powered by a large power supply, which supplies 24 volts for the machine and 36 volts for the laser module. The laser module is very large. I don't know how many diodes it includes, but it either uses 12 or 16 standard diodes or fewer more powerful ones. It has a selector switch which enables it to work with half the laser sources, cutting down power by half and reducing the laser spot size and increasing power delivery resolution for engraving more delicate materials. It has an integrated air assist tube and large heat sink inside for dissipating all the heat. The Z-axis can be driven by a stepper motor, or it can be adjusted manually. On the bottom of the laser module, there is an autofocus touch probe, which is used in conjunction with the focusing block, which has three steps, depending on the material thickness you are working with. Compared to its predecessors, the Atomstack A70 Pro has an improved mechanical gantry, which consists of steel rollers on all axes and a stronger and more stable frame overall. A very welcoming feature are cable chains. As on previous models, cables were often in a way when engraving larger stuff. One small letdown are the included cheap green safety glasses, which are not the best for such a powerful machine. This is why I use these affordable safety glasses that I bought online, which offer much better protection. I will leave a link in description. I am using my trusty old steel plate to protect my table, and with an air assist, using honeycomb makes a big difference. Now let's make a quick test to see how to operate the machine. The focus block has three settings, depending on what you want to do. Since I will be working with thin plywood, I will focus the machine on the tallest part. Focusing procedure is started by pressing the button on the control panel. The machine uses a probe to touch the surface of the focus pad and measure the distance. The Atomstack's laser module also projects a red crosshair, which helps to preview the location of the engraving quickly and safely. Thanks to its huge power, it engraves and cuts thin plywood like butter. Before making any serious tests, I wanted to measure its optical output power. Since my power meter only goes to 50 watts, I first measured the power of the 35-watt mode, and it showed a bit more than 30 watts of true optical power. Then I proceeded to measure the 70-watt range, but I have set the output to 50%. The power meter has measured a bit more than 32 watts, which translates to a bit more than 64 watts in total. This is a bit less than advertised, but still good, and measuring the power this way is not the most accurate. Then I proceeded to engrave my plywood engraving test pattern, which tests the engraving performance at different scenarios. Power scale test tests the engraving performance at different speeds and power levels. The interval test is there to check if the engraving performance differs in vertical and horizontal direction, which is often the case with rectangular laser spots of some machines. I engraved this pattern in 35 watt mode and its 70 watt mode, which has double the engraving speed, so we can compare the results. Looking at the results, we can see that the Atomstack has a good smoke management, since it doesn't produce so many smoke stains thanks to the air assist. If we compare the results of the 35 watt mode, we can see that it just slightly falls behind the 40 watt machines, but it is much better than the 33 watt machines that have more comparable power to this one. If we look at the pattern that was engraved with the 70 watt mode and double the speed, we can see that the pattern is a bit lighter, which was expected. But the engraving speeds here are very high, and you can see that even 70 watt machine is struggling with power here, while some 20 watt machines are advertised to reach those speeds where they will not be able to engrave anything. Next on the line was my standard anodized aluminum engraving test pattern, which produces very crisp engraved lines. It tests the machine's precision by engraving very small text and testing its mechanical stability by engraving a set of squares at speeds, ranging from 100 to 10,000 millimeters per minute. And the interval test is used to measure the laser spot size and shape. I have engraved the same pattern with both power modes to see if there is a significant difference in the laser spot size. This machine performs well at small text engraving in both power modes. Machine also has a good mechanical stability at higher speeds, but at corners the machine is slowing down and reducing power for compensation, since the heavy head takes more time to accelerate. At the interval test, I noticed some artifacts in both cases. I'm not sure why this happened, as it hasn't happened with any machine so far. The laser spot size is just a little bit smaller on the lower power mode, measuring 0.1 times 0.15 millimeters. The next test on the list was the focus distance test, which allows us to see how fast the laser spot size diverges with greater distance. This is important information needed for cutting thicker materials. This test was easy to do, as the machine can adjust the engraving height in real time by setting the Z-axis offset in light burn. I engraved four squares at different distances from optimal focus, which is represented by 0 millimeters. It is cool to see that the machine can adjust Z-axis in real time, as this saves me a lot of time for this test. But mainly, this feature is used for laser cutting. The Atomstack has performed very well in this test compared to other machines. This means that it should be a good laser cutter, which is what I will test next. Next, I tried to cut 3 mm black acrylic at 600 millimeters per minute. Machine was able to cut through in a single clean pass. The edge looks nice and clean. Then I went for 10 mm black acrylic at the same speed, and it could cut through in 4 passes, which is of course the best result so far. The cutting performance stayed strong throughout the entire thickness of the material. Then I went to run my standard test pattern for cutting 3 and 6 mm plywood. It tests the machine's cutting performance at different speeds and number of passes. The Atomstack A70 Pro is of course the best performing diode laser so far, and here is how it compares to 40 watt machines. In comparison to the 55-watt X-Tool P2 CO2 laser cutter, it is still slower at cutting, despite having more power than the X-Tool. I also made a quick test, cutting a 10 mm plywood, and the Atomstack has cut through in a single pass at 300 millimeters per minute, and it took just a bit over two passes at 600 millimeters per minute. Then I went to cut an 18 millimeter thick pine board, and the Atomstack A70 Pro was able to cut it in only three passes. This is a very good result, and the cut is nice and clean. The next test on the list was the 36 millimeter thick spruce plank. I focused the machine at the lowest setting, and the Atomstack was able to cut through in 13 passes at 600 millimeters per minute. The surface is incredibly clean, and the cut is nice and straight. Then I wanted to cut it on the taller side, measuring 44 millimeters. I used 3 millimeter thick board for bringing down focus on the lowest possible setting. It also did it in only 13 passes. This time, the cut was made across the grain, but it is still clean and straight. The Atomstack A70 Pro has a motorized Z-axis, and one cool thing you can do is set the Z-axis offset, which adjusts the cutting height in real time for each pass. This way, the cutting performance can be greatly improved. Then I went to test how well it can engrave stainless steel. Since I am keeping the same slow speed for all machines, this test is getting a bit ridiculous, as at 200 millimeters per minute at full power, it burns through this 1 millimeter thick stainless steel plate. The plate also starts to bend due to all the heat. Then I tried a more reasonable approach at 10 times the speed, and it was much better. I also engraved the same pattern on 35 watt mode to see how much thinner the engraved lines will be. The machine can also be used in an offline mode, engraving directly from the USB drive. Its touch interface enables you to perform all basic functions needed for engraving.